Hello students, in this video I will be discussing the solution of one-dimensional wave equation by separation of variables. The procedure will be similar to what we did for one-dimensional heat equation. So we consider u of x, t which is displacement because if you take a stretched string, now different points on the string raise to different heights at different points of time. So if this is at time t equal to t naught, it could be something like this. At t equal to t1, and as you can see, at each, if I take this as x equal to 0, this as x equal to l, different points on the string are raised to different heights. Therefore, we have displacement u to be a function of x and t. Now, the unit of c squared on working out will turn out to be meter per second. Unit of c will be meter per second. Therefore, and u represent, u being the displacement, the SI unit for u will be meters. So when we are rearranging the functions of x and functions of t, we need to ensure that c is along with time t, because c into some unit of time will result in, the product will result in the unit of length, which is what we require to represent u. So we have u of x, t equal to x of x into t of t. Dou u by dou x will be x dash of x into t of t, dou squared u by dou x squared will be x double dash of x into t of t, dou u by dou t will be x into t dash, dou squared u by dou t squared is equal to x into t double dash. Now we substitute these derivatives in the given PDE, which is equation 1. So this results in x of x into t double dash of t equal to c squared x double dash of x into t of t. So we separate the variables as before. Now the answer that we require, that is u, has unit of length, that is the SI unit is meters. Now c, which is having a unit of velocity, that is meter per second, needs to be combined with functions of time so that we get an appropriate solution. Therefore, we bring c squared along with function of time so we have separated functions of time and functions of x. Since small x and small t are independent of each other, their functions, if it is equal, that is possible only if it is equal to a constant k. Therefore, we have two equations which results in डी स्क्वायर टी बाई डी टी स्क्वायर्ड माइनस सी स्क्वायर के टी इक्वल टू ज़ीरो, विच आई कॉल इट एज इक्वेशन टू. एंड एक्स डबल डैश बाई एक्स इक्वल टू के, विच गिव्स मी डी स्क्वायर्ड एक्स बाई डी एक्स स्क्वायर्ड माइनस के एक्स इक्वल टू ज़ीरो, विच आई कॉल इट एज इक्वेशन थ्री. So we need to solve equation 2 and 3 for three possible cases of k. For the first case, we choose k equal to 0. So 3 reduces to d squared x by dx squared equal to 0, which is d squared x equal to 0. The auxiliary equation would be m squared equal to 0. The roots are 0 and 0. So we get x equal to c1 plus c2x into e power 0x, which is c1 plus c2x. Similarly, we have d squared t by dt squared equal to 0. Since we have similar equation as capital X, we can write the solution similar to capital X. So we have t to be c3 plus c4t. So u of x comma t will be c1 plus c2x into c3 plus c4t. Our understanding of wave phenomena tells us that this is neither periodic with distance nor with time. Therefore, this cannot be a physically feasible solution. So, we have to look for other possibilities. So, again, we solve equations 2 and 3 for the case when k is positive. So we take k to be p squared, where p is any real number. So we get d squared x by dx squared minus p squared x equal to 0, that is d squared minus p squared x equal to 0. The auxiliary equation is m squared minus p squared equal to 0, which results in p and minus p as the roots of the auxiliary equation. So x will be c1 e power px plus c2 e power minus px. Similarly, d squared t by dt squared minus c squared p squared t equal to 0 will give us d squared minus c squared p squared into t equal to 0. The auxiliary equation is m squared minus c squared p squared equal to 0. So we get m equal to cp and minus cp. Therefore, t will be c1 e power p ct plus c2, or we need to change the c3 and c4 e power minus p ct. As you can see, c has a unit of velocity and we have time. So the product ct will have a unit of distance, which is what we require when we represent the displacement which has a unit of length. So we find c1 e power px plus c2 e power minus px into c3 e power pct plus c4 e power minus pct. As you can see, this also does not represent periodic nature of the displacement of the string, either with respect to x or with respect to time t. Therefore, we look for the last possible case, which is k less than 0. For case 3, we take k less than 0, which forces us to use k to be equal to minus p squared, where p is any real number. With this, equation 3 reduces to d squared x by dx squared plus p squared x equal to 0, which is d squared plus p squared x equal to 0. The auxiliary equation in this case will be m squared plus p squared equal to 0. The roots are ip and minus ip. Therefore, x will be c1 cos px plus c2 sin px, because the value of beta is p and alpha is 0. Similarly, d squared t by dt squared plus c squared p squared c squared t equal to 0 gives us d squared plus p squared c squared t equal to 0. The auxiliary equation in this case will be m squared plus p squared c squared equal to 0. The roots of the auxiliary equation will be ipc and minus ipc. In this case, beta is pc. That gives us t equal to c3 cos pct plus c4 sin pct. So u of x comma t is c1 cos px plus c2 sin px into c3 cos cpt. Let me rewrite this. So u of x comma t will be c1 cos px plus c2 sin px into c3 cos pct plus c4 sin pct. As we can observe, the displacement is periodic with respect to x and periodic with respect to time, and therefore this would be the physically feasible solution for the displacement of a stretched string.